In the last session, we have discussed about what is a polynomial, how to classify or differentiate the polynomials based on the number of terms and also the degree of the polynomial. In this session, we will learn about zeros of a polynomial. To understand zeros of a polynomial, first we have to understand what is the meaning of value of a polynomial. To understand that, let's take a simple example. Let us say our polynomial P of x is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Now, let us say that instead of x, I have substituted value 1 there. It will become 1 square minus 5 into 1 plus 6, which is equal to 1 minus 5 plus 6, that is equals to 2. Now, the value we obtained by substituting x equals to 1 is known as value of the polynomial at x equals to 1. Now, what's the meaning of value of polynomial? If we want to find out the value of the polynomial at x equals to 2, simply what we will do, we'll take the polynomial and substitute the value of x. So it will be 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 6. That is equals to 4 minus 10 plus 6, that is equals to 0. Let us try one more. Let us say P of 4. P of 4 will be 4 square minus 5 into 4 plus 6. Now, this is the value of the polynomial at x equals to 4. That is 16 minus 20 plus 6. That is equals to 2. Now, let us say we want to find out value of the polynomial at x equals to 3. Now, what will happen? It will be 3 square minus 5 into 3 plus 6. Let us simplify that. We will have 9 minus 15 plus 6. That is equals to 0. Now, we understood what's the meaning of value of a polynomial. Now, what is the meaning of zero or zeros of a polynomial? The zeros of polynomial are the values of x for which the polynomial becomes zero. Now, we have different values here. P of 1, P of 2, P of 3, P of 4. Out of them, check where the polynomial is becoming zero. Now, here, when I substitute x equals to 2, the polynomial is becoming zero. When I substitute x equals to 3, the polynomial is becoming 0. That means 2 is a 0 of this particular polynomial. 2 is a 0. Similarly, 3 is a 0. So let's have a recap of this, what we understood. Let's understand what we have discussed just now. If we want to find out the zero of a polynomial, what we have to do? We have to take the polynomial, substitute different values into it, and check whether it is becoming zero or not. If the polynomial value is becoming zero, then that value of x or the corresponding x value is the zero of the polynomial. Now, is there any other way how you can find out the zeros of a polynomial? The other way what you can do is, let us say suppose somebody has given me 2x minus 4 is my polynomial. They asked me to find out the zeros of the polynomial. I know that when I have x value substituted with some value, the polynomial will become 0. So why can't I go and equate the polynomial to 0? 2x minus 4 equals to 0, that means 2x equals to 4. So x equals to 2, then I can write down 2 is the 0 of the polynomial. So we understood what's the meaning of value of a polynomial, what is the 0 of a polynomial, and how to find out the zeros of a polynomial. We have looked at one example, which is a linear polynomial. Now let us look at quadratic polynomial. Suppose we have been given the polynomial x square minus 6x plus 8. That is a polynomial in variable x. So we write down P of x equals to x square minus 6x plus 8. Now we have to find out the zeros of the polynomial. What we will do? We said that the polynomial value will become 0. So can I write down x square minus 6x plus 8 equals to 0. Now you know how to solve this. This is a quadratic polynomial. You can use splitting the middle terms and you can easily find out that x minus 2 into x minus 4 is equal to 0. That means either x minus 2 equal to 0 or x minus 4 equals to 0. Which gives us that either x equals to 2 or x equals to 4. So in this scenario, the zeros are the roots of the quadratic polynomial are 2 and 4. Now let us try some example problems on how to find out the value of a polynomial. Check whether a particular value of x is a zero of a polynomial or not, and also how to find out the zeros of a polynomial. Let us consider this polynomial. We have been given p of x equals to 5x minus 4x square plus 3. We have to find out the value of the polynomial at x equals to 0, at x equals to minus 1, and at x equals to 2. So we know what to do. What we have to do? We have to just go and substitute in place of x the value of 0. So let us do that. 5 into 0 minus 4 into 0 square plus 3, that is equals to 3. Now can you finish the remaining 2 in the same way? Next let's look at this problem. Verify whether x equals to minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of polynomial p of x equals to 3x plus 1. What we have to do to check whether the given value of x is a 0 or not? We have to directly go and substitute and check are we getting 0 or not. So 3 into minus 1 by 3 plus 1, that is equals to minus 1 plus 1, that is equals to 0. So x equals to minus 1 by 3 is a 0. Let's go and try one more problem. Let us say suppose we have p of x equals to x square minus 1 and x equals to 1 comma minus 1. So we want to check whether 1 and minus 1 are zeros of this polynomial or not. What we have to do? Do p of 1 and also do p of minus 1. P of 1 is 1 square minus 1, 0. That means 1 is a 0. P of minus 1 is again minus 1 whole square, that is 1 minus 1, 0. So that is also a 0 of the polynomial. So this is how we can verify whether a particular value of x is a 0 of a polynomial or not. Now let us see some examples on how to find out the zeros of a polynomial. Let us say suppose we have P of x is equal to 2x plus 5. We have to find out the 0 of this particular polynomial. We know it's a linear polynomial. So what I have to do? Take the polynomial, equate it to 0. So we will have 2x equals to minus 5 or x equals to minus 5 divided by 2. So the 0 of the polynomial is minus 5 by 2. Let us try one more example. Suppose let us say we have P of x equals to 3x minus 2. Again, what I have to do? Equate it to 0. 3x minus 2 is 0. 3x equals to 2. That means x equals to 2 by 3. So the 0 of the polynomial is 2 by 3. Now let's take some quadratic polynomials. P of x equals to 2x square minus 7x plus 3. So we have to find out the zeros of this particular polynomial. So what we have to do? We know that we have to equate the polynomial to 0. So 2x square minus 7x plus 3 equals to 0. Now we have to split the middle terms. So our sum is equal to minus 7 and product is equal to 6. Can I write it as 1 and 6? Sum needs to be negative, so minus 1, minus 6. So can we write it down as 2x square minus 6x minus x plus 3 equals to 0. Take 2x common, 2x into x minus 3 minus 1 into x minus 3 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 1 into x minus 3 equals to 0. So we can write down 2x minus 1 equals to 0, or x minus 3 equals to 0. That means x equals to 1 by 2 or x equals to 3. So the zeros of the polynomial are 1 by 2 comma 3. What's the meaning of that? We substitute x equals to 1 by 2, we should get 0. Let us check that. P of 1 by 2 equals to 2 into 1 by 2 whole square minus 7 into 1 by 2 plus 3. That is equals to 2 into 1 by 4 minus 7 by 2 plus 3. That is equals to 1 by 2 minus 7 by 2 plus 3. That is minus 6 by 2 plus 3. That is equals to minus 3 plus 3, which is equals to 0. Now, as we got, we verified whether the answer we got is correct or not. We checked that the value of the polynomial is becoming 0. Therefore, 1 by 2 is one of the zeros of the polynomial. So, in the next session, we will understand about remainder theorem and then factor theorem.